Okay, so we are going to be doing a speed run today on just how to make a quick 45-second to 1-minute project for TikTok or Instagram. This is what the final project is going to look like, and then we're going to get into cutting it, so if you will. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we would normally start a new project, but I'm just going to duplicate this project since we have the dimensions. Actually, no, you know what? I will start a new project. So we'll wait for this beach ball out. So move to trash, file, new project. And this is a pretty beginner project, so we do want to go vertical. If you were to do a horizontal landscape, you could do 1080p or whatever your preferences match. I always like to do HD. We're going to call this speed run. And I am competing with my dishwasher and the wind outside, so the audio might get a little bit crazy. The first thing I like to do really is, looks like we're competing with a little bit more, but I like to lay down a, it could be any color. I normally grab this custom. And then we're also going to find the audio. And the audio I just got from pulling directly from the vinyl, so you can hear where it's a little overdriven. Yeah. And that's where it's not really good. Right over here is the cut that we want. So we're going to need to boost that audio, which is not going to be an issue. And then you get this little thing. And then right over here is actually a nice little pop, like a vinyl pop. So I'm gonna keep that as well, and we're just gonna mock that in because I'm just so good at dropping the needle, I just don't even get that pop anymore. No, I'm joking. It does sound a little bit nicer when you add the pop into the, and then you wanna definitely fade these, but we can get into audio later. So we had like 1, 2, 3 of me opening this thing up, and recently I've been noticing that, it pains me because I pride myself in doing like full motion shots between a few different shots to create a greater sequence. That's just not how the world works anymore, and that's just not how people really want to watch videos. So these quick cuts are kind of what we want. So you can even see the spike in audio where I lay the bag down. So there's the Amazon bag, boom. And then from the same clip, we're gonna just tear this thing open somehow. Okay, scrubbing. All right, let's see. Scrub. Oh, here we go, perfect. So there's my address if anyone wants that. Okay, right there. And I got the knife in hand, so I'm doing this very responsibly. So as we go along, I'm gonna just kind of get this all squared away as far as framing so that our playback isn't, so we need to go a lot quicker, so that our playback isn't small and horizontal. And then we're gonna go pull this guy out. So you can click I and then you can click O in and out to grab your clip, copy, and then you want to do Command Shift V to paste like that, so that should work. Boom. And then we'll show a little zoom in, I think that's what we do. And this is kind of cheating, but these are the clips I've used, so hopefully I can, oh, here you go, here's what I can do. Boom. What about that? I think it comes out of focus, which I'm not too excited about, but let's see. Look at that. What if I did this? And then we extend that. I'm getting a little carried away. Boom. So this could be my matching the frame. I mean, before it bounces out of focus, it's all right. Let's see it. Yeah, see how it goes out of focus? There you go. And then what we could do is we'll just take this right here. We're going to stabilize this a little bit because it is a pan. And normally when it's smooth like that, I don't have a problem stabilizing it when it's just for like a little bit of a backup. But when it's completely wonky, then that's when I do have a problem stabilizing. So let's see. Can you tell my sense of urgency is... Okay, we're gonna get that out of there. And I honestly do think, here we go, I do think that the clip that I had is the only stable shot I take. These I'm not so privy on getting like a million shots till it's correct, because this is just, you know, it's for TikTok. It's fun. It shouldn't be too much. It really shouldn't. So I'm gonna go ahead and get this guy out. So the needle comes off the thingy, and I really don't spend too much time unscrewing it just because I don't want to lose audience on that. So we'll do this, boom, right here, and then boom, like that. And then, so my hands are in a different position, and that's going to bother me. So what we can do is we can just stretch the clip out, take something from up here, hope that it's correct. Always check. Yeah, okay, cool. So it looks like my hands have not entered frame yet. So right now we're kind of playing a guessing game, which really isn't the most proficient way to boom, just like that. But sometimes it pays off. And when you're working with this thing down here, make sure that your screen doesn't go black, because sometimes what'll happen is you won't realize, but it'll be like that. You don't want to do that. You want to make sure everything's tucked together, just because we're not on a magnetic timeline, since we put that piece of I just don't even know what to call it at the bottom. I think it's just a solid. I think they call it a solid. So let's get this thing on now. So this is another way you can scrub through footage, is literally just taking a big giant part of it, putting it down here, and then cutting it up. So I'm kind of using two methods right now, which is actually scrubbing through up here where the footage lives outside of your timeline. And then I'm also scrubbing through the actual timeline. I've been editing since seventh grade and I'm 26 now, and I really don't know which one I like better. So I don't have a preference. All right, this shot, again, I only did it once, so I'm gonna cheat and just pull it from the timeline where I know it's gonna work. There you go, a little Taylor Swift coming out, boom, just like that. All this right here is render, and in a normal day, I would let it render and do its thing, see what I mean? Issue is that this is a speed run, so we gotta move quick. So I don't like to have it wait too long. I like to get to the point on these, so let's throw this in, boom, like that. Let's see, boom. Because I'm so gentle, yep, with the little... okay, so when I was filming, I did this a little out of order. Again, I did not take like three shots of me clicking play and turning this thing on. So we're just using the one that I used in the previous one. We're not gonna scrub through, so that's on. Now, we're gonna do that. On, play. Okay, so... So now here's the fun part, is we're gonna find the spot where I grab the needle in, out, and we're gonna put that down there. And so, no, that's not it, sorry. We're gonna go back up here. Here we go. Huh, interesting. Okay, yeah, sure. And I'm not gonna look back at the other one just because I think that that's, again, cheating. So we're gonna do this shot right here. I know my hand is out of focus, but the middle of the vinyl is in focus, so that's fine. I'm not really too concerned, because what we're gonna do is, whoop, we're gonna cut over to this closer shot. Yup. And again, it's already highlighted, so I do apologize that I'm kind of cheating on that. So what I like is we're going to go fast to slow. Whoop. So I'm going to pull this clip out again because I shot it in high frame, so it is going to be a slow motion clip. And we are going to grab it like around here so that we can fulfill that motion of grabbing the needle. And let's try to match it up. Seems about right. And then you never want to have it where you're, you know, where you start the motion. You want to be fluent with the motion, if that makes sense. You need to make sure that my hand isn't like, it needs to be fluent from the very beginning. All right, so let's cut this up. Oh, this is already, and I like this fast to slow. Needle is dropped. You can check thumb and focus. Boom, right there. I'm gonna make a cut right there. You don't need to do this, but I'm gonna make a cut right there so I know exactly where to put this audio. And then we can throw that there. So this spike in audio should match up with this right here. And then the rest is just throwing some B-roll in. So let's get this nice close-up shot. And then we're just gonna cut to the music. Yep. So one of the big things I like to do is either cut on a kick or a clap because they are both very prominent in songs. So let's see. We're gonna do another clap. And then we're gonna introduce the album art. So I'll take a different piece over here. And so, yes, so let's flip that 90 degrees. I know I'm gonna wanna stabilize it. See what I mean? It's a little wonky. And then I like this because it says the tracks. And then when she says it's me, we should definitely throw in Taylor Swift like this. And then we can cut that and throw another one of her in. And I'm not really sure exactly what, I know this is the same order, but I'm really not sure where these come in the other video in lieu of the vinyl, because I do like putting the vinyl back in. So remember that the vinyl is a little bit different in the sense that it is flipped on a different axis. So let's do that and we'll do it on that clap. Boom, another clap. And then we got two more of her. So again, I'm just gonna cheat and grab that. Boom, like. Okay, we're gonna do that. Grab this shot of her on the back of the vinyl. I like to get every shot of the vinyl. And then we're just gonna go back to, I guess, the wide to finish us off, right? Right around here. Why not? Yep, that looks about right. And then I can, maybe we'll go in close or something like that. Or honestly, if we're doing the end, we should do it backwards. And then this is a nice little trick. Put your playhead right next to that and you just cut it real quick. Yep. And then cut. And since it's TikTok that this will be going on, it could be a jarring cut at the end. It does not have to be a slow fade out, because the thing about like slow fade outs and everything is that no one's really going to care about that on TikTok. They're just ready for it to loop back. So all the video that I do, any type of movement, I'm going to stabilize again, because it's not jarring movement and it doesn't really need to be stabilized. It just will take it over the edge a little bit. There we go. And make it look like a fluent head, because some of them I'm using a tripod, some I'm just going handheld. I'm trying to be extremely cautious of how stable I am. And so now we are just waiting on render speed, and I'm gonna go ahead and cheat and do color correction, which really is a I want to use that in a light term, because I really don't think I color corrected this much. I just kind of threw on a little bit of color to not make it look so warm, because I did film this at night with lamps, so we are waiting on that render speed now. All right, now that we are rendered, I'm gonna go back in here and I'll show you a little trick. So it's the trick I've been doing. So you could copy, and with these two, these four, okay, these I know we just want the color one, boom, and they're a little less warm, just a little. They still have a bit of like a vintage look, because, and I'll go in and show you what I did. And so then all the other shots are gonna get this treatment. And the only reason I know this is because I just edited this video last night and posted it on TikTok. So that's a little bit less warm, little less warm, little less warm. There you go. And so another thing is you can click Command 7 and kind of look at your how your exposure and color is looking over here. So everything is meeting the highlights besides these shots. So you could really go in and navigate, you know, reaching that highlight. And look at me being lazy and using the color board. These are the color wheels, and you can get a bit more range with these. So now that I did this, I could copy that, and that's gonna be color wheel 2. That's fine. So color wheel 1 that we want to copy and paste over. Don't copy and paste everything else, because you'll get another color board on it and it'll kind of mess up your color. Kinda, it will. And, you know, again, these are all very quick shots. I'm not really looking for the best results on this. I like this a lot, but obviously since I'm filming this by myself, I can't really see what I'm doing. So this gets a little muddy and shady. This does too, but we're working with what we got. We definitely are. And again, this is just a quick video for Instagram that I'm trying to cut in under 30 minutes. So we're gonna let this render out. We're gonna export it and then play them side by side.